So, hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. I still haven't improved my setup, so you will see here still hear some crackling noises and stuff. But in this, we are still learning sort of setup. I wanted to talk about something called co-design. And the reason for this is many people have asked me, do you work for small rig? Sometimes I have to admit I'm a little bit confusing because I'm talking about we instead of them and stuff like that. But yesterday somebody asked, please, and somehow this is, seems to be a valid question on YouTube, you have to explain your relationship with this company, because otherwise, I'm not sure what otherwise would happen, by the way. But and it's probably also not meant in a bad spirit. I guess it makes sense that you, if you do do commercial work, you disclose that you are doing that. It's actually in the rules from YouTube. But as far as I know, I'm not breaking any of the rules. If somebody explains me differently, I will definitely listen. But I wanted to talk a little bit about co-design. So the first thing that you see is my iPad, and basically I put on the page where they are talking about what co-design is. And it's a really sort of explanation about that you design something together with a group and do something called participatory design. Yes, I got it, the whole word out, which has all kinds of ideas behind it that you design together with your clients, right, or a group. And then iterate, and it's quite a difficult sort of system, and there are books about it, and please go and read them. But I want to be a little bit more practical, and while answering the question, is Small Rig paying me for some of the things that I've done for them, and they are doing for me, by the way, because I think it's a two-way street, I also wanted to make the opportunity to explain that they actually know they don't pay me, and nobody pays me for the stuff that they do at the channel at the moment, except you by clicking and maybe use the links below my videos, which I only started like a week ago. I think so far I've earned $1 something from Amazon. Not sure how that's going to work out, but that was also not the reason. The reason why I'm doing it, so again, Small Rig is not paying me, but I'm helping them in designing some of these products. And while thinking about this question, it's also something that for me is something very natural. I'm coming from a software design background, and in fact I did a lot of open source software. I was a paid open source developer for several years. And even our current software, most of it that we use in the company, we open source. We actually not only open source it, we do open development. So that means that anything that we do in certain products that we have, the moment that I sort of make a change, the rest of the world can see it. So it's kind of in my nature. It has always been in my nature, because I was yesterday thinking about this question. And for this new studio setup I'm making, which is a little bit more professional than the one that we had before, I actually had to get a really old box back. So let me switch to another camera, which is this one. Yeah, there it is. You probably have no idea what this is, but this is called a high-end scaler. I used to be, and I'm still kind of into home theater, so it's a little bit dusty. It has not been used for over a decade. But I might actually use it in a new video setup. So on the back you see that it's basically a video switcher. It was probably, it goes to 1080p and it has all kinds of professional sort of inputs for that time frame. This little box cost me, I think, about $5,000 or euros. Can't remember. But when I was thinking about this whole question, I remember that again, this was like 15 years ago. I remember talking to the designer, one of the hardware designers who makes the chips inside, and talking to him about features I want to have added. One of the things I wanted, which is kind of technical, but the screen I was using, I if you go to a movie, it's a different aspect ratio, and I actually wanted to have more control over the aspect ratio so I can move the picture up and down to put it on the correct height in my home theater. And they added this feature. They asked me, what kind of a name do you want it to give? And I ended up adding several things to their menu, and they implemented that for me. This is like 15 years ago. So this is not like, well, I'm not sure if this 15 years was pretty old. I'm not sure what age that is. So that's kind of a natural thing for me sort of to do, right? So I'm going to just show you some stuff that I'm now doing with Small Rig, and I'm going to use them as an example. Again, they're not getting paid. They have no idea I'm making this movie. I will probably post it to their Facebook page, because they have two Facebook pages which I you can join, which basically allow you to help in their co-design stuff. But of course, the discussion came when we are using or working on this one, the 2236 L bracket. But before that one was this one. I want to have a grip, which they we co-designed. And the old L bracket, which I'm proud to say is their one of their best-selling products at the moment. I can probably claim quite a bit about this one, probably fully about this one. And I will show you another one which I'm kind of proud of. I did way less on this design, by the way. Of course, they talked to me and I talked to them. But this is nothing special, right? This is something that you can all do. And that's going to be my argument. And I'm going to show you what happened with a small item that I co-designed. And I'll have to open my iPad and show you what we are talking about. Because I was kind of upset that about this little part. And you might be a photographer and you have no idea what you are looking at. So let me show it from above, and maybe I can even zoom in. Ooh, yeah, we can. You can see it's a really small part called a cold shoe that you can put on top of your camera or your camera rig, and you can put like a microphone in there or a monitor. Well, these monitors are getting more and more expensive, so it might drop out. So I wanted to basically have a way to lock it down. So I've saved a few pictures, and let me go through it, how it's kind of started. So I went to their website, which they do, and I'll let me first show that, because I think that's probably a good idea. So let's go back to the website, and so there is their website. And again, I know this sounds like an ad, but if I would almost say if they deserve it, I'm fine in sort of talking about it, because I like companies which are open to help in co-design. Just to show you, because I'm kind of proud of this, these are their hot selling topic products of last year. And I'm happy to report, if I order by best selling, that you can see that the L bracket that I designed or helped design, co-designed with them last year is the third place selling product. And probably, well, I think the first one, the cold shoe I'm going to talk about, because I think this should be replaced with the one I'm going to talk about, and it should be the best selling product of next year. But if I press on this one, you can see that depending on if you really get accepted as co-designer, they will put your name there, and there you see my name, which I don't think is important. Sometimes they do it, sometimes they don't, but this is now their best-selling, I would say, expensive product, right? Now, of course, I can be upset that they didn't pay me for it. And again, they did not pay me for it. They did send me two copies, actually. So a prototype or a pre-production type and a production version. So that's all the payment that I got. Now, trust me, if you hire me in a normal way, that would probably, I'm not as expensive as a lawyer, but it definitely would cost a lot more if you look at it that way, right? So, the nice thing about this, you can just go to their website, and you go to, in the top, you see an item called co-design. There it is. You can press it, and they will explain to you how the process works and what is currently in co-design. For example, I really would like this item, which is a thing on that you can put a monitor on top of your rig, and you can also swivel it around. So that's something, whoops, I'm sort of not helping out, probably not co-designing, but giving comments back about it. And they have two Facebook groups. So here you can basically see the products they are working on at the moment. And if you join one of their Facebook groups, you can sort of help out. That's it, right? So let's talk about a real item, right? So the real item I want to talk about today is this one. I was still upset about that something can drop out of this. So what happened, I went to their Facebook group and I actually posted this message. So let me find it. Of course, I'm still going to be me, so things might not be always as organized. And I thought about this, doing this talk. Oh, please tell me that I did save my first question. Oh yeah, well, there it is. So I posted this question. Why can't I have this with expensive gear? I want small but protected. Small rig should keep innovating. I was kind of making fun of them. And I made a drawing. I also sent them to one of their designers. I'm in a lucky position that I've now talked to them so much that they kind of talk back to me also, let's say in private channels. Nothing weird going on, just more direct communication. So I kind of explained, why can't I have this part, right? So the next thing that happened, let me find the next picture, is that they said to me, this is way too small, we can't design this in this a little lock into this part, that's way too difficult to do. So, and then I made fun of them. I said, well, your company name is Small Rig, not Big Rig, so why can't you do this? And then they kind of replied in which I'm sorry, I find it still quite funny. They kind of reacted in two different ways. Within, I think about, this was 15 weeks ago, right? So this product has been on sale for quite a while already. So about 10 minutes later, they said, well, hi, I will reverse the words. I have to say blah, 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 that they are happy with my comment, but they were kind of upset that I made fun of them. So a few minutes later, they actually sent me a picture. Well, let's go back to this page. Again, for a second, they sent me a picture. This picture that they in China, while I am in Amsterdam, got together a part of that design team and they were making a drawing about how to design it just to send it back to me. And then they later posted, I think also the Facebook group, or I posted it on the Facebook group, that they were already working on it. This was like an hour, maybe 2 hours after I posted this, right? So, of course, they are a company. They are doing this in the end for money. They talked about it probably internally and said, well, this is actually a good idea to try to solve. Let's see if we can solve this problem and make money because it's a company. But for me, I just want to have this part in the world where this is locked, right? So I think that's where sort of, let's say, the changeable world is, right? If you are doing something for fun or you want to have something created, please go out and talk to companies. I will, at the end of this talk, show you some of the other stuff that I've been using in the last few days, including the last thing I got from Small Rig, so that the new L bracket, and I'm already thinking about what to tell them next to put on the next model. I hope this makes sense. So they sent me this picture, and the next thing that kind of happened is, let me see, they admitted that they were working on it. And of course, everybody in the group, and there are, I think, also a few thousand people in this group, which all comment on products that they want to have designed, right? So they were like, okay, we will start making it, and they will start asking questions of when will it be done and how will it be done, etc., etc. So again, going to this one. Remember, I sent them kind of this drawing, right? My beginning drawing. So within a few days, I think this is actually the second design. They first actually, and I didn't save this picture, but first they sent us two options, like a cheap option and an expensive option, and they let everybody in the Facebook group vote on it. And most of them picked this design. They tuned it a little bit, but this is actually what got built. So they made several prototypes, and they sent me one of the prototypes. So here we go. Let me zoom in on the table again. It's quite small, so I'll have to put down my iPad. So there it is. And here is this really small little part with a lock on it. Now, I of course didn't think about the next part. It would be fun to show you how it works. But I'm kind of assuming that you know how this... well, let me get something, because otherwise, if I don't make a messy video, then what's the fun, right? So let's assume, I think this is going to be a cool part to show it on. So let's assume that this is on top of your camera, right? For example, on the new half case that we are, you see that I now say, let me first, because I'm pretty sure, I'm hoping that I will send this also to Small Rig. When I say we, it almost becomes like a community, right? But keep in mind, they are doing 90% of the work, all the calculations and figuring everything out and stuff like that. But because it becomes a community, you kind of forget about it. So before I forget, let me thank a few people, especially because these are the four people which currently still work there that I talk to a lot. So let me thank Chen and Emma and Bill and Tracy, because they have worked on most of these designs. Of course, they do most of the works, and I have no idea what other people internally are working on it. And I guess some manager at some point has to approve the design and put it into production. But sometimes I hear myself slip up and say we instead of them. And I guess that's also why he asked this question. So let's talk about this part. This is sort of a small tool to, if you have two audio channels on your camera, or you want to lock this in. But if you have this on top, and also a microphone on top of this, well, let me switch to this one, right? Then you can imagine that it can be quite heavy, and on the old one, it would... Of course, I didn't repair this part. So let me open it up and put this part in. It could drop out. I hope this makes sense. I think this is quite a visual sort of demonstration of the problem. Oops. Okay. Clear, right? So on the new one, it's kind of the same. You lock it, you slide it in, but you hear that it locks. I had not seen it before, and I've checked with quite a lot of people who also didn't see it before, and I've showed, of course, you still need to, in a normal way, put it up like this. But this is now a part that's in the world. You can buy it, right? You can go to the website, and let me find it. Because that's, of course, the end point, well, kind of the end point. So after a few weeks, they sent me two as a prototype. So I guess I got free stuff, because they cost, I think, €8 a piece. So they sent me two to sort of check if they would work for me and if they make sense. And later they sent me two other ones, so I probably got paid like €16. And I think at some point, just to be totally clear again, because now I have, I think you have to have over like 3,000 subscribers, and they are willing to give you a reviewer state, and then you also get stuff. And I don't think many companies demand you to send stuff back. I refuse to do that. My idea about the channel, and I'm kind of also developing that idea, is that I will only accept, would be the wrong word, but take things that I wanna play with and I think I can improve. I might be open to accept these and play around with them. And if I, for example, destroy them because I'm fiddling around with them, I won't be sending them back. So that will probably be kind of the deal. So after they sent me the prototypes, of course, everybody online were quite happy. And you can see that I'm here thanking Emma from Small Rig, and Bill, who was designing it. And you see, in fact, Kathleen, which was one of the members of our Facebook group, sorry to call you out by name, said, well, that was kind of quick. This went from idea to production in a few weeks, which indeed was true. And you can now buy this part. Let me find it on their website. So there we are. There you can see, we can buy it. I still have 529 on stock. And probably what happens normally after a few weeks, they go into the Amazon sort of queue. And in this case, it was designed by Bill. And they put my name there again. Again, sometimes they do it, sometimes they don't. And now you can get this part, and this part is into the world, right? So, I understand that this not fully explain maybe my logic, but I don't think I can explain it. I think there are people in the world who like to fiddle, who like to improve, and there's only the, let's take the Sony cameras, right? I've been trying to get in contact, and some of you know this, if you're on the Facebook group, with several people at Sony to talk about their software, right? And to try to not complain, but try to help out. Of course, you're not getting paid for this, but for me, it's kind of the way that I want to give something back. I know this may sound a little bit corny, but I'm quite happy, for example, to see this L bracket clearly being used in a very nice picture that I saw online of a Northern Light picture, where somebody took a picture of the person making the picture of the Northern Lights, and I clearly saw that this L bracket was being used. That makes me smile, I have to admit it. If I see a part showing up on my favorite Dutch store, which I won't name now, but and I see one of the parts that I helped on their website, I get a small smile. I'm like, that's kind of fun, right? So I will walk to my laptop and see if there are questions. But I think many of you on a Facebook group, and I don't want to be, maybe I shouldn't say that like this. I know that on the internet, or maybe in general, people think that designers, either software or hardware designers, are not willing to talk to you. They are, not all of them. Every company will talk to you. But in the last 30 years, I've had both in software and in hardware, people respond to me if I just email them. And most of these companies have also nerds inside, even in Sony, even in Apple, even in Oracle, even in an old company you probably have never heard of called Sun Microsystems, which are working on something called Java. You might be surprised if you start talking to a company how willing they are to talk back to you, right? So the last thing I want to do, just to give you an idea, and again, none of these companies will probably pay me. Well, probably I won't accept it because I have a job and it will be way too difficult with taxes and stuff. Like I said, I might be open to accepting some stuff to work on. That might be fun. So let me show you by turning on my camera, because I couldn't figure out another way to do it. So the picture will be quite bad. But I will be showing you, oh, we already are on this picture, so sorry for showing you my legs. The picture is quite bad, but so this is the setup that I was using, I'm using now, and I was using last week. So this is, for example, is a little box that does the streaming. It's a really small box. I got it last week. I really like it, but I found some problems with it, and I really like them to change it. So I will start emailing them. I paid for it, right? It's like a 400 euros something box. It's really cool, and I will review it somewhere next week. It's now sending the stream to the internet. You can see that there you can have a remote application, and if I press the green button, you will all go away. Although you can't see that it's green, I think. Maybe I can. Ooh. I'm now using my iPad as a camera, which is maybe a tiny bit weird. So then we have this box, which is now my video switcher, so you can see that I can switch away from it. So there you are gone, and there. You can even do more funky stuff, which you're not supposed to be doing. At least I don't like doing that, and all kinds of interesting things. The biggest problem that I have with this box is listen. it makes noise. It's made for DJs, so that makes sense. They have a lot of noise anyway. You can actually hit this button and give it a beat, and then it will switch automatically on the beat of the music. I don't want to use it for that, but I want to open it up and see if I can replace the fans, and also talk to them and tell them, hey, this is a perfect tool because look how small it is, and you can switch 4 video channels, and the audio is really fine, and you also have an external iPad application, so you can totally control it from your software. You can see that these two boxes combined with my iPhone, I have a totally portable setup. Imagine that. I can have in my left pocket, I can have this box, which is about the size of an Apple TV. It works on USB power, which is really cool. I don't, of course, will have the switcher with me. In the other pocket, I will have my iPhone. They will be talking over Wi-Fi. I have a small cable, and I could theoretically use my A7 R3 or the A7 III or whatever camera I want to use, which you can see I still have a kind of an ugly setup because I'm now thinking about how to actually create a small studio in here to do this more often. And you can see that I hacked up 2 monitors, so there's the switcher and stuff. But imagine that in my left pocket I have this small box running on some USB power. In my other pocket I have my phone, which is doing the 4G, which is cool, right? And then I could use any camera and walk around the city and doing the same thing with you guys and show you around live. How cool is that? Now, I do want to have some extra features in the software. For example, this is a perfect what we call monitor to look back what you are doing. You can even listen to the audio. I won't turn it on because then you will hear the sound going weird, going to ring. It even works, which is kind of cool for this, because it's just an iPhone. I can even put earplugs in, the earbuds in, and then I can listen. But I don't have any audio meters, which is kind of silly because, well, the application clearly has the audio, so why don't you give me the audio signals there? So I have all kinds of ideas. I want to start talking to these companies, and some companies talk back to you. Now, let me put something in the image of a company that wanted to talk back to me. At least I sent them a few emails and they didn't want to do it. So if people recognize the brand, they didn't reply. But lots of companies are more than willing to talk back to you and talk to you. And and that's kind of what I'm doing. So I will now walk to my laptop and see if maybe some people have questions. I do want to stay kind of on this topic because I think otherwise it becomes way confusing. But I hope for the person who asked the question that I have explained more clearly that I'm not really getting paid, but I do get sometimes some free, let's say, parts simply because it's a prototype. Or they have sort of the rule that if you have co-designed something, they will give you a free copy of it. That's all explained on their website. They even have a program, which I should show you before we go to questions, if there are questions. I should show you one more thing, because there's kind of, I would almost say, 3 levels of working with this company, and other companies might do it differently. That's why I like using Smorik as an example. It's one of the few companies that I have seen in this, let's say, photography / video space that is as open that I've seen. They even so you can go to the Facebook group and you can join in the discussion. So that's one way. The other way, which I'm showing, but you have to read the page yourself, is actually one step further. If you, because I showed you a really stupid drawing of me, right? Just showing, hey, I want to have this lock. But if you're much more handy with 3D equipment or drawing programs, you can actually send them your 3D drawings. And this is explained here. It's called a dream, create your own dream rig. And they explain to you what you need to do, make a sketch, we will review it, we will manufacture it, we will send you a prototype. I think, but I'm not sure, I think it will be sent free to you. Never tried it, because I'm using the third option. And, there is even some kind of a reward. You are not doing this for the money. You are doing this because either you need the part yourself, right? Or Yeah, you just enjoy fiddling around with stuff. And this, I know I sound like I'm doing a sales pitch for a small rig, and I'm pretty sure, well, I'm not sure if they actually like me talking about it in this way, but let's assume that they don't mind me talking about it in this way. But if you look at some of the high-end camera brands, which they also make cages for, so the high-end Sonys, the Red cameras, and Blackmagic cameras, stuff like that, they are more expensive. But lots of time, people have a need for a very specialized sort of part. And they use this dream rig sort of setup to design the part themselves. Sometimes it's also a community, so sometimes people help each other. So somebody comes in and says, hey, I kind of want to have something like this, but I don't know how to put this in a 3D program. And somebody else jumps in and thinks it's fun to work with 3D applications and designs it for them. And it goes into this whole design sort of process where they check it and then they can see if they can make it. Right. The third way, which before we go to questions, the third way is kind of my way, maybe because it's I wouldn't say helping out, but before last year when I got really serious about it and I helped on I think 4 or 5 different parts, I already sent them a few ideas on the A6000 and the A6300 cages. So it's probably been like 3 or 4 years. And in that time, and that's kind of guess the third way, and they might reach out to many people, I have no idea, but I kind of started having relationships with 2 or 3 of their people, and we probably, even sometimes over Skype, but mostly using Facebook, we message each other sometimes at the weirdest hours of the day, because I'm in Amsterdam and they are in China. And we send pictures about drawings and talk about stuff. Sometimes also about how the weather is and what they are doing and how their holiday has been. But that's what happens if you get in touch with people on the internet. So that was kind of my defense. A really long defense is small rig paying for you, or are you a spokesperson for small rig? So now I got my computer, and I don't think there are any questions. So the good news is, well, I guess that's good news, because that means that this video will only be 30 minutes, and it won't be all confusing at the end. The last open chat that I had was like 2 hours long, so. There's nobody watching, which is a pity, but that's also not a problem for me. So there are two questions. So let me see the first one. X-Ray had just a small rig rocks, which I agree with. And I have the full case, full catch cage, I think, but thinking of swapping it out for the new L bracket that we are just designing, for the Panasonic GH5. Cool. And an X-Ray had also said, really nice video switcher. I agree, and I will talk about the video switcher in a later review. But again, if of course I might review it simply because I think it's fun. Again, nobody's paying for me for that. I might get a few dollars a day from the ads from YouTube, but that's about it. But I will definitely contact them and talk to them and suggest how they can improve it. So since there are no more questions, I will stop this live stream. And I think this is going to be a habit. So I will also do it today because I think it's really cool. Maybe just be me being weird. So here you see the application, right, that I was talking about. And there's a record star button, so I can stop the recording internally in the box, which I've now done. Click. So in the small Apple-like box, it's stopped recording to the flash card, which was attached. And if I press this button in 3, 2, 1, you will be gone. Bye-bye.